So you might be at a stage in your career where you feel invisible in the office, people don't listen to you in meetings, you don't get invited to co-worker lunches, your boss doesn't remember your name, and your overall contribution doesn't get noticed. For any ambitious emerging leader, this isn't a good situation to be in. If you want to advance in your career, you need people to know who you are, what you're working on, and what contribution or success that you have achieved. So let's look at exactly how you can do that and feel more visible in the office. The first thing you need to do is to make sure that you are present. And what I mean by that is present in conversations, present in meetings, and present in important decisions. I find that a lot of people who feel they're invisible in the office actually make themselves invisible. They don't contribute in meetings, they sit at the back of the room in meetings, and they avoid casual office conversations. All of these situations that I've just mentioned are opportunities for you to be visible in the office, to be more visible around your coworkers, your boss, and other important leaders inside your company. If you avoid these situations or these visibility opportunities, the only result will be is that you'll be invisible in the office. So what should you do instead? How can you be more present around the office? Well, the first thing you need to do is make sure you say something in every meeting that you attend. I'll talk more about this later on in this video. The second thing you should do is to physically be present in conversations and also in meetings. Don't avoid those conversations and don't avoid those meetings. The third thing that you can do is stop thinking that casual chats around the office are a waste of time. This is where relationship building happens and it's where you develop your reputation in the office. The second thing you need to do is have an honest one-on-one conversation with your boss, and you need to let them know that you want more exposure in the office. You want to work on more high-level projects so you can connect with senior decision makers and senior leaders inside your company. This will tell them that you are ambitious and you really want to advance in your career and advance fast in your career. The thing is, your boss may not know that you are so ambitious. A lot of the time when people go unnoticed, it's because their boss doesn't realize they are so ambitious. Their boss doesn't realize they want more high-level projects or more visibility inside the company. They might think that you are just happy sitting on the sidelines doing the work that you're currently doing. If you want more exposure, if you want more high-level projects, then you need to tell your boss this is what you are interested in. Here's how you do it. You email your boss and schedule a one-on-one meeting with them. In that meeting, you tell them how much you are enjoying the projects you are currently working on. Then you ask them how you can get involved in high-level projects. These three steps will help you communicate to your boss that you are ambitious and that you want to really advance in your career and have more exposure around the office. Plus, the one-on-one conversation with them will help you gain more visibility in front of that person as well. Number three, be more outspoken in meetings. Meetings are a time where you might hide or you might try to be invisible in the room. You might think that your opinion doesn't matter. You might be shy or scared about sharing your opinions or your thoughts in front of the other people in the room. Perhaps they're more senior. Perhaps you feel they're more intelligent than you. Perhaps you feel they're more experienced than you. As a result, you might sit at the back of the meeting room and say nothing, therefore becoming invisible. What you need to remember here is that meetings are a free and easy way for you to gain visibility. Visibility in your company, visibility in your department, visibility in your team. Think about it. Every meeting you attend, there's a number of people in that room. There's your coworkers, and there's also possibly senior leaders as well. This is your chance to get visible in front of those people all at the same time and for free. So becoming more outspoken in meetings and actually communicating your ideas, communicating your opinions in meetings is a free and an easy way for you to gain more visibility. So it's definitely something that you should try. Now, how can you go about becoming more outspoken in meetings and being less of a wallflower? Well, it's really about preparation. I want you to prepare 1 to 2 topics that you want to talk about in that meeting. You can also aim to respond to 1 or 2 people during the meeting, respond to what they've said, respond to their ideas as well, ask questions, show interest. These two things will help you gain more visibility inside that meeting room, and that will then spread to the rest of the office outside of the meeting afterwards. If you want more advice on how to speak confidently in meetings, then you should watch one of my earlier YouTube videos, How to Speak Confidently in in meetings. I'll link to it in the description below. Number four, build internal relationships. This means you need to build relationships with your coworkers and really get to know them, get to know who they are. What this does is it helps you build a support network inside your company, people who can support you and also people you can support in return as well. Support networks are really important for any emerging leader or any ambitious professional because those astute professionals who advance really fast in their career always have a support network, and it's probably one of the major reasons why they do advance so fast in their career. A support network, it's basically a group of people who can cheer you on. They can help you raise your visibility, and they can increase the impact of your ideas when you share them in meetings or share them with other people around the office. So it's definitely something that will help you raise your visibility overall in your company or even in your industry. Now, how do you go about building internal relationships? Well, the first thing you need to do is to get to know other people in your team. Get to know who they are, what they like, what they're working on, what contribution have they made to the company, and also know a bit about their personal life as well. Second, ask about their job, what they're working on, and really listen to their answers, really show interest in what they're telling you. And this will entice people to ask you more questions about your job, what you're working on, and what your contribution to the company is. So getting to know other people in the office, showing interest in them, will definitely help you raise your visibility and have more impact in your job. Number five, become known to senior leaders. As well as developing relationships with your coworkers, people who are generally on the same level as you inside the organization, it's also really important to develop relationships with senior leaders in the company. So what I mean here is people who are decision makers, people who make hiring decisions, and people who can have an impact on your future career. Since most hiring decisions or promotion decisions happen when people know, like, and trust you, you really need to get inside the circle of know, like, and trust, and you really need to start developing that with senior leaders and hiring managers, people who could be in charge of your next promotion. Now, how do you do that? One idea is to start speaking up more in meetings. I've already talked about this in this video, but basically when you speak up more in meetings, in front of those important decision makers, in front of hiring managers, they notice you more. So it's definitely something that you should try and you should start to do more often. You can also say hi to them in the office when you pass them in the corridor or when you arrive at the office in the morning. You'll be surprised at how effective saying hi every day for weeks or for months on end can be to your career. You can also organize a one-on-one with these senior leaders if you get to know them a bit more by speaking up in meetings, by saying hi to them around the office, or even exchanging with them on LinkedIn. They'll be more likely to schedule a one-on-one meeting with you. And in this meeting, you can ask them what is required for your career advancement, what is required for you to get promoted. This tells them that you are ambitious, that you want to get promoted, so it kind of leaves that thought in their mind, but it also helps you understand what exactly you need to do in order to get promoted. This information is very valuable and it will definitely help you fast track your career growth and get promoted much quicker. Number six, develop your personal brand on LinkedIn. I was just talking about interacting with senior leaders on LinkedIn, but developing your personal brand overall is an amazing way and very effective way of building your visibility in the office or in the company and even in your industry. LinkedIn is a powerful platform that allows you to share your thoughts, your ideas, and your opinions as well with people inside your company and also outside your company. By liking, commenting, or sharing other people's posts, your coworkers' posts, or senior leaders' posts, it helps you to become more visible in front of those people. They'll start to notice you on LinkedIn. They'll start to understand who you are on LinkedIn and what value you can bring, what contribution you add to the company. This will then carry over into the office. And when you see people in the corridor, when you see people in meetings, when they hear you talk in meetings, when they hear you contribute your ideas in meetings, you will become more visible. You will already be known to them. They will already know who you are. And when you share your idea in that meeting, it will again amplify your visibility around the office. I have some steps that I want you to follow if LinkedIn is something you want to work on. The first thing I want you to do is to like 1 to 5 posts every day. This should take you about 5 minutes every day. The second thing I want you to do is to comment on 3 to 5 posts every day. Now, this will probably take you about 10 to 15 minutes to do. I also recommend you create 2 to 3 LinkedIn posts every week. This will absolutely help you build your visibility, especially on LinkedIn, but also in the office. Now, if you want ideas on how to create content for LinkedIn or get some ideas on what content you can create, I'll link to a video below, which is about content creation ideas for LinkedIn. And my last tip for you is to realize that you are important. You were hired for your role for a reason, because you're good at what you do, because you provide value to the company. A lot of the time when people feel invisible in the office, it's because they don't actually realize the value that they contribute. They don't realize the impact they've had on the team or on the company. It's easy to overlook this. It's easy to get caught up in the day-to-day tasks that you need to do. And it's also easy to let your negative inner talk take over and convince you that you haven't contributed anything. So to combat this, I want you to go to your most recent performance reviews. Have a look at them. What were the positive things that people said to you? What positive comments did you receive? What recognition did you receive? What contribution did you make? Write all of this down on a piece of paper or a notebook or your phone. Keep it with you where you can reference it and you can go back to it whenever you're in those moments where you feel you haven't contributed anything to the company, when you feel that you are invisible in the office. Go back to those notes, look at them again, read them again, and remind yourself of why you were hired in the first place. And realize that you are important. Above all, don't assume that people will notice your hard work and your contribution. A lot of the time, they don't. You really need to bring it to their attention and make it more obvious to them. Otherwise, they do miss it. Now, I have a number of other videos on my channel about building your visibility and speaking up more in meetings. It's a topic I'm really passionate about. So I will link to those videos in the description below if you want to check them out. If you are a regular viewer of this channel, thank you so much for coming back. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you're new to this channel, then make sure you subscribe by hitting the button below this video. Every week, I share videos on leadership to help you advance in your leadership journey. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you again next week.